Students, let us continue our chapter Forest and Wildlife Resources. In this third module of Forest and Wildlife Resources, today what we will do is the types and distributions of forest. As the first one is the type forest. In this, the government of India divided Indian forest into three parts. The history of Forest Department of India is very long. Actually, it was started by the Britishers when they realized the importance of forest, because it is forest from where they get their raw materials. So they appointed one forest expert from Germany who became the first forest officer of India, and this is how the forest law implemented in India by this. And after independence, the three types of forest which are found in India, the first one is the reserved forest. Reserved forest means the permanently earmarked either to productions of timbers or other forest produce. There is a right of grazing here and cultivation is seldom allowed. It total cover the total 54.4% of total forest area is covered with reserved forest, and more than half of the total forest are regarded as most valuable forest in this reserved forest. As far as the conservation of forest and wildlife resources are concerned about it, so these are the reserved forests. Now the next type of forests which are found in India is the protected forest. Protected forest. In protected forest also there is a right of grazing, as like in the reserved forest, plus somewhere cultivation also allowed here. The subject to a few minor restrictions are here. 29% of the total forest area is covered with protected forest in India. Almost 1/3 of the total forest area is protected forest as declared by the Department of Forest. This forest land is protected for the any further depletion. The next one is the unclassed forest. Unclassed forest means these forests are not classified whether they are comes in the reserved forest or protected forest. The owners of these forests are private persons basically, or they are the open forest, consists largely of inaccessible forest or unoccupied waste. These covered 16% of the total forest of India. So as we see in these three, let us understand all these forests with the help of a pie diagram. The first one is the reserved forest. The reserved forest is the maximum forest area of India is covered with this reserved forest. In this reserved forest, this is 55%, a little bit permission of grazing and cultivation is allowed. The next one is the protected forest, which is 29% approximately, and the next one is the unclassed forest. This unclassed forest is approximately 16%. So students, let us come to the next part, and that is the type of forest and the distribution of types of forest. Accordingly to the density, In this, first comes the dense forest in India. This dense forest occupies 59% of the total forest land of India. Next come the open forest, which cover 40% of the total forest land of India. And the third type of forest according to the density is the mangrove or tidal forest, which is approximately 1% of the total forest land of India. So here also we can see that through this pie diagram, the maximum part of India's forest is dense forest, and this much part, 40% part, is the open forest, and the tidal forest is only 1%. The next is the distribution of forest in India. If you see the distribution of forest, then Madhya Pradesh has the highest number of forest, that is the 75% total land area comes under permanent forest. The rest from the other states, which we can easily understand through a diagram of India, map of India. In this map of India, what we discuss is the total forest areas in the year 2000. In this area is the percentage of total area of forest. First of all, let us discuss those areas which are comes in the dense forest areas. This map is according to the density of forest area, while here Madhya Pradesh comes in first on the criteria that its maximum largest area are under the forest. Here the states comes are like this Himachal Pradesh and Northeast. The areas where the forest is not very high but it's a high dense areas comes 40 to 60% are the states of Madhya Pradesh, obviously Maharashtra. This is Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Karnataka, obviously Kerala also, Andhra Pradesh and Odisha. They all comes in it, and our Assam is also comes in it. The area where forests are found, 20 to 40% are basically it's Assam region of India. Actually, and now comes the that area which is the rest part of India, which comes under this, that is obviously Jammu and Kashmir, Rajasthan, Gujarat, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, West Bengal, and maximum part of Tamil Nadu. So this is how we see the distribution of forest. Now the next thing which comes here is the and this is the community and conservation. Forests are also the home of many traditional communities in India, many parts of India like Madhya Pradesh and other parts are struggling for it to conserve these habitats along with government officials. Governments also takes many steps for it, like in Sariska Tiger Reserves, Rajasthan, villages have fought against mining by citing the Wildlife Sanctuary Act. The inhabitants of 5 villages in Alwar districts of Rajasthan have declared 1200 hectares of forest as the Bhairav Dev Thakur Sanctuary, declaring their own sets and rules in this area. Not only in these regions, but in the western part of Rajasthan also there is a community, Bishnoi community, also doing such type of steps in favor of wildlife. Sacred groves, as we discuss here, Bishnoi communities also. The forests are god and goddess for many communities in India, where they do worships of many sacred crops, as like Tulsi, the Khejri tree in Jodhpur and western Rajasthan. Also, not only this, but many wildlife also like Chinkara, Nilgai and peacocks can be seen as an integral part of the community, and nobody harms them in Bishnoi community. There are many famous movements also, like the Chipko movement in the Himalayas has not only successfully raised deforestation in several areas, but has also shown that community afforestation with indigenous species can be enormously successful. This is what was happened in the history of Rajasthan also, where there was a Chipko movement by Amrita Devi, started in the medieval period. Beech Bachao Andolan in Tehri and the Navadyan have shown the adequate levels of diversified crop productions without the use of synthetic chemicals are possible, and they are the economically viable. And the last one is the JFM, that is, in India there is a joint forest management program furnishing a good examples of involving the local communities in the management and restorations of degraded forest in India. This program has been in formal existence since the year 1988. So this is how we see the role of community also in India for the conservation of flora and fauna. So this is how we complete our chapter in 3 modules, forest and wildlife resources. Any kind of doubts, if you have, or anything what you want, any more knowledge, whatever is your comment, please comment to me. Thank you. We will solve and give you reply also. Thank you again.